Hey everybody, it's the Burger Dude, and today we're going to veganize the iconic sandwich from Chicago, the Italian Beef. And I've never had one of these before going vegan, but I can tell you that this was one of the best sandwiches I've ever made, so I must have done something right. To start, let's make the giardiniera, which is a spicy pickled veggie condiment, and it's one of my new favorites. We're going to make ours from scratch using a recipe by Brian Lagerstrom. I'll leave a link in the description for his original video. It's pretty simple, but it does take a bit of time to let the veggies brine and hang out, so if you want, you can totally use some store-bought stuff like this, which is not a bad move at all. I totally love this stuff as well. But for homemade, all we need to do is chop up equal amounts of cauliflower, some carrots, a green bell pepper, and then we're gonna do some celery, and next some serrano peppers, which his recipe calls for only doing half as many peppers as the other veggies. But in retrospect, I wish I would have doubled these, as the giardiniera wasn't as spicy as I would have liked, so add more if you like things spicy. And there you go, they should look something like that. And next we're gonna make our brine. So let's get some water, a little vinegar, and then some salt in a pot, and we're gonna bring that to a boil. I'm also adding in some chili flakes and some oregano, and I was just kind of improvising here as per usual. And after we get that up to a boil, let's add in our veggies, and then we're gonna turn off the heat and let that cool down to room temperature. And once that's done, do your best to get as much of it as possible into some kind of container. I had a dickens of a time getting it in this jar, but I may do. And then we just wanna throw that in the fridge for about 2 days. All right, it's 2 days later. Next, we're gonna strain the veggies from the brine, and then we're gonna add them to some jars and cover them in oil. And the original recipe called for a mixture of olive oils, but I'm opting for soybean oil, but do whatever you prefer. And then we just gotta store them in the fridge again and let them hang out for at least another day or two before using. I know it seems like a long time, but the stuff was really freaking good. I found myself just eating a spoonful here and there for a quick snack, so it's definitely worth the wait. And now on to the beef. And for this, you can really use whatever you like. You could do seitan or thinly sliced mushrooms. You could even use soy curls like these. But today we're using yuba, aka soy skin. It's basically the layer that forms on top when they're making soy milk, and it has a really amazing texture and it soaks up flavor like nobody's business. And the kind I'm using I found at Whole Foods, and admittedly, they're not as cheap as the dried frozen kind you can find at some Asian markets. So definitely check there if you can. But they were incredibly easy to work with and didn't need to be rehydrated. As you can see here, I'm basically just unfolding them. This one kind of looks like an ancient book, but you just need to keep unfolding, and then I'm simply gonna rip them into shreds. And this recipe calls for 2 packs or 10 ounces, and that was probably enough for 2 really large sandwiches or 4 smaller ones. And once you got your yuba shredded up, let's make our jus slash marinade. And so first we want to use about 3 cups of this beefless broth. You can use veggie broth, but this beefless stuff is going to be beefier, if you can imagine that. It's also worth noting that I'm totally improvising here, but I also made more of this stuff the next day because I honestly loved it so much that I had to make it again. And the second time I made it, I followed the recipe that evolved over the course of this video, and it was totally fantastic. So to our broth, we're gonna add 1 teaspoon of oregano, 1 teaspoon of dried basil, 1 teaspoon of dried parsley, 1 teaspoon of onion powder, and 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, and then 1 teaspoon of red chili flakes, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, and then 1 teaspoon of what's this here sauce, and then as much black pepper as you like. After that, I ended up adding about 2 tablespoons of molasses as well, which will help with the meaty flavor and color too. And now all we need to do is simmer the yuba in the jus for about 30 minutes. I ended up adding 2 tablespoons of this mushroom seasoning in order to boost the umami profile, and it totally worked. I also used this red yeast rice powder for color, but again, the second time I made this, I skipped that step as it wasn't really necessary, but do whatever you like. And honestly, all you really have to do is watch this, stir it around for a bit, but you really just gotta simmer it for about 1/2 an hour, and then after that, it should look something like this. And I gotta say, I really dig how this came out. It's tender, but has a bit of a chew, just like how I remember roast beef and French dips. I'll definitely be experimenting more with it in the future. Now let's talk bread. Initially, I figured an Italian beef would be served on Italian bread, like these amorosos or gonellas, I'm sorry if I'm totally butchering that. But apparently it's served on French bread. And since this sandwich is pretty wet from all the jus, and since we're gonna be dipping it as well, you really need something that's soft on the inside, but has a good crust so it won't fall apart. I recommend getting something from a local bakery like this if you can, or just make it from scratch if you want as well. And now all we gotta do is build our sandwich. So let's split open that roll and stuff it with as much of that vegan beef as we can, and really don't be shy and try and get as much of that jus in there as well. And then add as much of that giardiniera as you like. And we're gonna top that off with a little bit more of that jus, and there you go. I don't think it really gets much better than that. And now I'm gonna try and wrap this up as best I can. I apologize for my lack of grace. I've only ever delivered pizzas and been a busboy, so this is the first time I've ever wrapped a sandwich like this. And next, we'll slice it in half, and there you go. There's a little cross section for you. And now some people like the entire sandwich to get dunked in the jus all at once, which makes for a pretty wet sandwich. I'm not that wild, so I'm gonna dip as I go. I'm not sure if this is breaking Illinois state law, but I'm from California and I do what I want. Speaking of doing what I want, it's worth noting that I've eaten no less than 3 of these over the past 2 days. It's a super simple sandwich, which, as we all know, usually means it's also super delicious. Everything works so perfectly. You got the salty, savory vegan beef, the spicy giardiniera, the jus, which just makes the whole thing richer and more decadent, and then the French bread holding it all together and adding a little bit of sweetness. It really is a perfect sandwich with few contenders. So, obviously, I highly recommend you make this sandwich, and if you want to make some other fantastic sandwiches, check out my videos for a Philly cheesesteak and a French dip linked right here. Those are both out of this world, too. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.